This is three quick tips on online assessment and the tools that I use. One of the things I use is rubrics, and a rubric or checklist can help students with performance assessment. It gives them a chance to look ahead and know what they're striving for. One example would be to use a simple PDF rubric, maybe something that you currently print out and pass out in your classroom. Another example is the Blackboard interactive rubric. And in my example here, I've added a rubric to my discussion board for participation. And you have the ability to show the rubric to students ahead of time. By default, it's set to no, and I've changed that so that they can see it and that they can see it with the rubric score. So this gives them the opportunity to see how their performance will be measured ahead of time. Another thing that's good for online assessment is some examples or even some non-examples. Students can benefit from seeing what an assignment looks like when it's well done and perhaps some annotations on an example of an assignment that's not well done. Here you see an example of an assignment, and you can use the assignment files feature to maybe attach a file from your computer or the content collection that is labeled a good example and a non-example maybe that has some annotations on it, what's wrong with the paper. So students could actually take a look at this before they submit their assignment. And the last thing I wanted to share with you is just student questions. You know, often you get these in the campus classroom and you answer them verbally. And you answer them over and over again, and sometimes that can point to something that may be missing in your instructions. But rather than answering the question verbally for each student, you could put it in a frequently asked question or FAQ. I use a Blackboard Wiki tool. And in this case, you can see that the wiki that I've created, I've called it Frequently Asked Questions. And I've got multiple pages for attendance, final exam, and grading, which are common questions that I get. And a wiki actually allows you to create new pages. So you can have multiple pages in one area of your Blackboard site and even editing. Now, I turn off the ability for students to edit this particular wiki. But it still allows me to kind of create a mini website within my course where I get multiple pages that I can quickly edit and add answers as students ask them. So those are three quick tips: using the Blackboard Wiki tool, using the assignment tool to attach examples. And the first one was using the Blackboard Interactive Rubric tool to give students an idea of what they or how they will be measured ahead of time.